this tutorial, we will show you a workflow for our 3D Max plugin used with Render As Is mode. Open your scene and forward it to the render beamer using the Beam It Up menu. Render As Is mode is the first mode on the selection list. It's a default render setup recommended for both testing and final rendering. With Render As Is, your scene will be rendered without changing any GI settings or render options. Render As Is mode can be used for scenes with single frame GI settings or with pre-cached GI maps. Just make sure your maps are correctly connected to your exported scene. You can use it for single frame rendering as well as animations. Below the mode selection panel, you can find the list of renderable cameras. You can turn on and off cameras directly in plugin UI without going to 3D Max settings. Next, you can set the render range for each camera. In our example scene, we will render all four cameras as single frame. Next, you can continue to the plugin setup. Here you can change some of the render settings for your scene, like override output or export as V-Ray standalone. For more info about plugin render settings, please check our dedicated V-Ray overview tutorial in our 3D Max plugin playlist. Generally, if you don't want to change anything and continue with the process, just use Send to the Farm button. Our plugin will start preparing your scene and project data to transfer to the farm. This process includes saving the scene and copying textures and all related project data. Once the preparation process is done, Render Beamer will upload your files to the farm file servers. To continue with the process, press the Click Here to Submit Job button and add a new render job directory on Web Manager. Once you see the job submission window, you can review some of the render settings. Please remember that the job submission window is the last step when you can change the render settings before adding scene to the farm. For 3D Max projects prepared with Render As Is mode, you can switch between cameras and scene states. You can still set different render range for each camera. For example, you can set it to render a single frame for each cam, like 10, 20, 30 and 40. You can also apply global frame range using the frame range field at the top of job submission window. If everything is okay, just click on the submit button. Now, all your cameras have been added to the farm render queue. Once rendering is complete, you can go back to Render Beamer and download the outputs. Just switch to the Download tab, refresh the list, and press Download All button. Now, Render Beamer will start pulling rendered outputs from the farm file servers. Now, let's take a look at the outputs. Just select Open Directory on the downloaded folder. As you can see, all outputs are here, including render elements and main output color. One level higher, you can find other rendered cameras. Here we got V-Ray Cam 1, 2, 3 and 4. So that's basically it when it comes to using 3D Max V-Ray Render As Is mode on GarageFarm.net. Happy rendering with GarageFarm! Thank you.